And let's just start by interlocking the fingers. We're going to place them right underneath the chin. We're going to focus that one point in yourself in the mirror. Make it 60 minutes all about you, starting with all weight in the heels, pushing the knees back, thighs tight, stomach in, and let's keep it moving nice and slow. We're going to inhale for 1, 2, slowly elbows up, 3, 4, 5. Let's lengthen and lift the elbows a little bit higher for 6. Good, exhale, 6. Let's look at the ceiling, 5. And as we keep looking farther back, 4, same time, the hands, palms. Now let's get the elbows to touch away from the chest. And as we inhale, nice, slow, elbows spread out like wings. We got your chin down, right? Parallel to the floor. Got to wrap the hands around the chin, frame the face of the forearms. Let's take a lift the elbows up and back, full lungs. Exhale now where we look farther back, right along the ceiling. Maybe it's along the sky, letting the head drop back. Slowly those elbows touch, now pointing up, up to the mirror. And as you inhale, it's gradually tracing the eyes down, down to you, right? Chin parallel to the floor. And again, wrap the hands around the chin. As we lift the elbows up and back, we're expanding the rib cage, full lungs. Exhale, keep the lift in the elbows. They never drop down. So your head dropping back simultaneously, the hands, palms, elbows touch up away from the chest, and let's go nice, slow, chin down, elbows up. So the slower the better, never in a race. The more you're gonna use your lungs. And when it feels like you're full, so you gotta expand your lungs. You gotta inhale a little more, exhale that pressure release. Make it a loud ha sound coming out of your wide open mouth. Not only getting rid of stale air, any stale thoughts, let's get them out. Elbows stretch forward and let's inhale, chin down, elbows up. Now inhale, mouth closed. You're breathing in through the nose. We feel that snoring vibration in the back of the throat and feel like you're full. What do we do? Inhale a little more. And then loudest ha sound, mouth so wide open. You feel a stretch in the jaw. We got head back, elbows stretch forward. Squeeze every last little drop of air to fully inhale, slow motion. Chin down, elbows up. Now all the while, chin down, elbows up, and all the while, lower body solid. So we'll go weight in the heels, knees back, thighs tight, stomach in and in as you exhale. So let's keep that lower body solid and contracted throughout the whole breathing, how building that strength in the legs. Your elbows stretch forward to the mirror, and let's go nice, slow. And as you're grounded on the floor, weight in the heels, thighs tight, chin down, elbows up. So you're grounded in the floor, chin down, elbows up, and you're gonna grow up. Gotta lengthen the spine, chest, get that little bit taller, wake the nervous system. Exhale now, maintain your length. Your heart's lifting up to the ceiling of the sky. Weight in the heels. We got elbows stretched forward, and we're gonna go nice, slow. And it's 3 more, chin down, elbows up. And I want you to think every breath got to be a little bit deeper, building that crescendo. Inhale a little more, and then loudest ha sound, getting out stale air from each, every cell of the body. So we got to fully empty, elbows stretch forward so you can fully inhale nice, slow, chin down, elbows out. Now we're literally saturating each and every cell with oxygen, energy. And then when it feel like your lungs are gonna burst, we inhale that little more. And then setting up, final breath, head dropping back, out hunching back. Let's round shoulders, elbows stretch forward. And you know, last one, super slow motion. I want you to feel like you're sucking the air from the four corners of the room, thighs tight, stomach in, the rib cage expands. You gotta inhale a little more, and then that smooth rhythm, head dropping back, loud ha sound coming out of your wide open mouth. Slowly the hands, palms, elbows touch, pointing, stretching of the mirror. Gonna squeeze arms, squeeze it all out, and let it go. Beautiful. So your arms are gonna float down. We go right in half moon pose, Ardha Chandrasana. We keep the toes, heels together. We're going to get arms up. So we're going to interlock the fingers, release the next fingers, thumbs crossed. You're going to lock those arms, ultimately the biceps glued against the head, palms tight as you can. Ultimately, there's no gap, light air between the palms. And with the weight in the heels, let's lengthen up and just start to bend right and left. You know, it's our little warm up, just kind of connecting to how your body feels today, right? It's a little bit different each every day. a little bit different on the left side and the right side. And then you're just going to connect to the breath throughout practice. Let's keep the mouth closed. Keep that breath flow steady and consistently. In out of the nose. That's your fuel for the postures. And let's go a couple more times, right, left. And then just once you hit the middle, we're going to stop there, stand tall. So right here, we got all weight in the heels. We go hips forward a little bit with the upper body back slightly. Now let's revisit those arms, right? Lock arms. Ultimately, it's like you got no elbows. Ultimately, there's no gap between the palms. So your tightest grip. Now that deep inhale, full lung stretch up. Bend right, shift hips left. Just where you meet that initial resistance, right? And we're now concerned about how far you're bending down. And more importantly, it's about creating that expansive stretch on the left side of the body. And we're focusing on your form, your arms, legs locked. So ultimately, there is no space between the biceps and the head. Palms tight and tight. We can start pressing the fingers into the back of the hands. Let's strengthen that grip, strengthen the wrist, prevent arthritis. And from the start, all weight in the heels, knees back, thighs tight, stomach in. Out your arms, legs locked, creating that dynamic stretch. Feel it all the way. Heels to fingertips on the left side of the body with the weight in the heels. Hips forward a little bit. Upper body back slightly now with that chin up and breathing steady. You got your form connected to the breath. You breathe to go deeper. Inhale, we're going to lengthen, stretch up a little bit. Exhale, get a push for those thighs, tight stomach in. Good exhale, come down and push. Yeah, right to the edge. Let's come right back up. All right, so arms still strong. We inhale. Let's give it that deep inhale. Full lung stretch up. Bend left, shift hips right. And again, we're in it for a minute. So pace yourselves, right? No need to kill yourselves right away, right? It's just about finding your form. Finding that connection to the breath, most important ingredient. So make sure right away, chin up, throat visible, breath steady, in, out of the nose. And you make those little adjustments, hips out of line, you work the right hip a little forward, shoulders out of line, you work the left shoulder forward. Now, so we got your arms, legs locked. So I want you to feel those biceps against the head. Feel those palms tight, tight. Ultimately, you cannot slide a credit card between. Now, from the start of the practice, all weight's been in the heels. Thighs tight, stomach in. Now with your arms, legs locked, feel it, that stretch on the right side. Now heels all the way to the fingertips, open the body, bones to skin. Now keeping the weight in the heels, hips forward a little bit, upper body back slightly. Now looking good. Now chin up, breathe steady, breathe into the stretch. Inhale, gonna lengthen, stretch up out of the waist. Exhale, gonna push, and you breathe normally as you push right down to the edge. Flexibility, gotta push. Awesome, right to the edge. Let's come right back up. Arms still strong. Want you to drop your head back, all the way back, like it's a big bowling ball. Just let it go. Now, still breathing in out of the nose. Inhale, gonna reach, stretch up to the ceiling, to the sky, and start going backwards. And you know, 99% of it, mental, right? You can go backwards. You start going for it little by little, tracing the eyes, arms back. Same time, I'm gonna push stomach, legs, hips forward. Hips are going more forward. Arms are going more backward as you feel it in the lower back. Now inhale, lift the heart. Now with that lift in the chest, you got to start, use the arms. Trace them along ceiling, along the sky. Got to look back, point back. And where you're looking, eventually pointing. So let's go back, way back. Four. Pray a little more. Yeah. Nice, Lauren. Let's come right back up. We're going to pause here for a second. All right. Lengthen up out of the waist. Keep the stomach in. And let's go the other way. Now, stomach in tight as you bend the knees as you need to. And then we're going to start dancing. That's our little warm up here, just shaking it out. Just kind of your legs, your hips, right, left, right, left. Remember, drop the head down as well. No need to hold the head up. We hold it up all day. So just kind of drop it down and we shake it out a little bit more. Doing a couple squat down bounces and it'll wake up the joints. And then we're going to look now, squat down halfway, cup the hands right underneath the heels, and let's go for the grip. Ultimately, you're going to get your pinkies side by side, stepping on the fingers. Now, if that's not currently happening, normal, right? You're working towards it, though. Just wrap the hands as far behind as you can. We're all going to bend the knees to get the elbows as far behind the calves. And once you have your best grip, starts with that steady pull. Pull the body down from the lower spine of the floor and want your body smushed against the legs. So I don't care if you bend the knees, but your stomach's on the thighs, Your chest is on the knees, and you're journeying that forehead right towards the shins, ultimately feeling that stretch all the way to the top of the neck. And as your body against the legs, you push the knees back and pull and lift the hips. I want you to feel your biceps bulging. Use that upper body strength, pulling, lifting the hips, 10 seconds, concentrating, meditating, unlocking the knees. Doesn't matter when, what matters, keep on trying. So you're gonna roll forward, knees back, pull, hips up, lock the knees, and then change. So we got flat back, arms, head together, gonna hinge at the hips, keeping the arms up there. And this is good, nice and slow. Arms are gonna float down, slow motion, building that control in the shoulders, and then chin up, chest open, and breathe. All right, we reset, focus, and redo. Round two, we get arms up, locked. And again, take time in the setup, and it's not the easiest thing, but you're trying to lock the arms. So ultimately, it's kind of like you got no elbows, and then you're trying to bridge the gap between the palms so there is no gap, right? And it should be hard work just doing this. Now, with the weight in the heels, give that deep inhale, full lung stretch up. Bend right, shift hips left. Now, as you enter the posture, right, the arms stay lock solid, right? They don't suddenly bend. If anything, a little bit more lock solid. Palms a little bit tighter than you think, right? Strengthen your wrists, and we got all weight in the heels. Thighs tight, stomach in, out. Arms, legs locked, feel it stretch. Heels all the way to the fingertips. That's line of energy. You're waking up your spine, giving energy for class. Inhale, I got to lengthen, stretch up. Exhale, got to push deeper, farther, push. Awesome, right to the edge, just come right back up. Arms still strong, weight in the heels. Give me that deep inhale, full lung, stretch up. Bend left, shift hips right. And it's always first foremost about your form. We meet that initial resistance. Got your arms, legs locked, hips, shoulders in line. All the while, chin up, throat visible, breathe, steadying out of the nose, right? And these last 10 seconds, a little smile helps. It does. Corners your mouth upside down. And inhale, got to lengthen, stretch up a little bit. Exhale, got to push, breathe. Normally, Sean, flexibility, got to push and push and push. And change and come back up. Looking good. Now, arms still strong. Drop the head back, all the way back. Now, inhale, gonna reach, stretch up to the ceiling and just go for it, right? Just tracing the eyes, arms back, pushing the stomach, legs, hips forward. That trade off, your hips go forward and forward, arms go back and back with the weight in the heels. Now inhale, lift the chest up like I'm suctioning your heart up to the ceiling. Now with the chest up, gotta go back, right? Dive back, look back, point back. Be not afraid to look back, point back, and more than you think. Try to fall back, you won't go. Four, three, a little more. Awesome, good, nice energy. Let's come right back up. Now feel that nice jolt of energy with your nervous system. We're gonna lengthen up, stomach in, and let's go. Other way, we're gonna hinge forward, bend the knees as you need. Place the hands on the floor and get moving, right? Little warm up again, just shake legs, hips, the head drop down, make sure everything is nice, loose, comfortable, and flexible. Down a couple times, wake up the joints. And let's go round two, Padasthasana. We're gonna squat down halfway, cup the hands right underneath the heels, so ultimately the pinkies side by side. Bend the knees to get the elbows as far behind the calves. And then get to work, right? Steady pull throughout, and I want a body leg sandwich. Stomach on the thighs, chest on the knees, ultimately part of that sandwich, forehead pressed onto the shins. Now, little by little, actively pushing the knees back. And as you pull, lift the hips up and up. And I just want you to think little millimeters, lifting the hips up to the ceiling, into the sky, so you feel that stretch all over the back legs, that little pain-like sensation in the back legs, it's working. You send your breath there. Now roll forward, knees back, pull hips up, lock the knees. And then we change. Flat back, arms, head together, hinge at the hips. You're gonna keep arms up there. All right, looking good, nice, slow, let it go. Arms gonna float down and it's stillness, breath. Reset, focus, and then we're gonna keep flowing along. Awkward pose, Utkatasana, gonna step right foot out, 6 inches about hip width distance apart for you. And make sure those feet parallel like train tracks, so important for your alignment. Now, arms up parallel to the floor. Elbows locked, triceps tight, five fingers together, reaching to the mirror. Now you're still breathing in out of the nose, most important ingredient. Now as you exhale, stomach in, sit right down. So go, bam, one motion in the chair. Got 100% weight in the heels. And you know how it is. Weight in the heels feels awkward. It's awkward pose. Now you reach like you're going to touch the mirror. As you inhale, I got to lift the chest. Arch the back. I'm going to restructure the back. Shoulder blades to the back while chest up. Lean back into the feet, into the heels. Lean into them and touch the mirror. And come up on the tippy toes. All weight, big and second toe, super ballerina time. Now we're going to visualize a wall behind you. And as you slide down, priority number uno, heels up and up and up. Relax your face, heels up and up. Now highest pair of heels, lean against that upper body, lean against that wall. Now breathing in out of the nose, your thighs burning, shaking. You send your breath to your burning thighs and hold. Mind over matter, 4, 3, 2, 1. Awesome. Looking good. Now, arms still suck. Keep your composure. Third part. Low bit in the feet. Jam the knees like it's one knee. We're going to visualize a wall behind you now. Straight spine. Somewhat relaxed face. Sliding down that imaginary wall. You're in control, right? You choose to go slow. You're breathing, steadying out of the nose. Upper body leaning against that imaginary wall. Ultimately, hips slightly above the knees, knees down, chest up, feeling pretty good. Maybe bounce a couple of times, just a little bounce and bounce. I hold it to the top and the bounce. Jam those knees. Now, this is where we're going to build that physical, mental strength. Choose to come up slow, upper body leaning back. Feel your thighs burning and shaking, right? Building that strength. Awesome. We're going to step right foot back, stand tall and breathe. Chin up, chest open, couple deep breaths. Eagle pose, got awesome. We get arms up. First things first, we go right under left, elbows underneath, palms to touch. You're going to work that grip. Now we're going to pull the elbows up, down, loosen up a little bit. Bend down into the knees, nice and low. So get low into those knees, keep the chest up together. We're going to go right leg high, up, over, and around. So it's like you're crossing the legs. Ultimately going to wrap the foot around the calf. Now you tend to hover forward, but I don't want to hover forward. So you got to keep actively lifting, arching the upper body back. Weight more to the heel, and then a little increment, sitting low. Twist the legs more as we pull the elbows down. Stomach in, a sink down, down low. And as we arch back more, hairline lower, and it's tighter. Squeeze, freeze. Awesome, tight squeeze, release. We get arms up, right in. Left under right, elbows and then the palms. Get that grip, pull the elbows up and down. Bend down nice and low. So just again, nice low under those knees. Keep the chest up. And then together, we're going to go left high, up, over, and around. Up, over, as we're going to wrap that foot around the calf. And again, we right away want to lift the chest. Looking nice, proud, open chest and eagle pose. Arching the upper body back. Little more weight of the heel. Little by little, sitting lower, twisting the legs more. All the while, going to pull the elbows down. And in as you arch back to the opening of the elbows, wrist, shoulders. As we arch back, go down and down. Squeeze tight, freeze, concentrate, meditate. Good hold down, and we get arms up. And then we get arms down, and then we breathe. Right, give it a nice deep breath, acknowledging your hard work. And then grab a refreshment. Enjoy. Party time. Right, so far so good. So once we go to that little refreshment, party time is over. We're going to step back to the mat, stand tall, ready to balance on one leg. So we start with your toes, heels together, just like you started the practice. And we're going to start shifting all your focus to the left leg. And the most important thing in your life right now, lock your left leg. So right now, pushing the knee back, pulling up in the thigh tight. Keep it like that, solid. Your right leg up, thigh parallel to the floor. In it for a minute. As you're ready, stomach in, round down to get your grip. Now, I want you to all remember, we're never racing through, right? Some of us may be a little more upright. Awesome, right? You are where you are for today. As you're ready, you round down, grab as far along as you can. Ultimately, it's that 10-finger grip below the toes. Now, it starts with that mental focus. Lock, lock the leg. 1 point, laser beam, concentration, obsession to lock your left leg. Pushing the knee back, pulling up on the thigh tie. There is no knee. Now, weight comes to the side of the foot. We press the big left toe down, down. Evenly distribute the weight on the foot. Now, if you're feeling that leg solid concrete, 10 feet below the ground, then only gently kick the right heel towards the mirror. Flex the toes. Now, some of you kicking the heel out, same time flexing the toes back, and we're pulling with the grip. Little by little, kicking, flexing, pulling, both legs lock. That's a go. Elbows down below the calves. Now, wherever you are, tune up that concentration, termination, press that big left toe down, stomach in, breathe steady, it's strong. Three, flex the toes, pull. Awesome. Nice. We're going to reverse out. Give that nice deep inhale. Nice deep exhale, and other side. Shift all focus to that right leg. Let's push the knee back, pull up in the thigh, no bend in the knee. Left leg up, thigh parallel to the floor. And as you're ready, stomach in, round down, and get a grip. And again, you have that option. Maybe you're a little more upright for today. No worries, right? Make it your focus to lock the right leg. As you're ready, round down, grab as far along till the 10-finger grip below the toes. Now, 1 point focus, lock the leg, pushing the knee back, pulling up in the thigh so there is no bend in the knee. And you know how it is, falling out is how we learn to balance. You fall out, you get back in. You fall out a trillion times, you get back in a trillion and one. Now, if you feel that leg 10 feet below the ground, not going anywhere, gently kick left heel towards the mirror, flex the toes back, kicking the heel out, flexing the toes to little by little, both legs lock. Now, so we go both legs locked, stomach in and in, working those elbows down below the calves. Now, wherever you are, it's breathing steady, flexing the facial muscles and holding it incredibly strong. Four, three, two, one. We're going to reverse out. We're going to go right in for hands on hips, quick little backward bend. Forget about it. Of course, we do it again, second set now. Now, half the time here, we still got toes, heels together for alignment. We're gonna focus all tension to the left leg, pushing the knee back, pulling up in the thigh. Right leg up, thigh parallel to the floor. Stomach in, round down, and get a grip, right? And keep that laser beam focus. 1 point, laser beam concentration, termination, lock the leg. If you're a million, billion percent sure leg locked, then only gently kick the right heel towards the mirror, flex the toes. As you kick, kicking the heel out, flexing the toes, toes to the face. You got stretching the Achilles tendon. Now, both legs locked, so got elbows down, down below calves. Now, wherever you are, pressing that big left toe down. As you're ready, we go. Chin in, stomach in, forehead, meet in the knees. Strong, steady, still, statue. Four, three, two, one. Awesome. Looking really, really good. Nice, Karen. Nice, Dan. Nice for you. I'm going to reverse out. And so give me one more. Okay, hang in. 30 seconds. Inhale, exhale. All focus to that right leg. And let's close it out. Left leg up. Thigh parallel to the floor. Out taking too long. You round down and get a grip and try your best for 30 seconds of your day. And again, it's that mental focus, right? All that matters, lock the leg, pushing the knee back, pulling up in the thigh, there's no knee. As your leg 10 feet below the ground, okay, kick left heel towards the mirror, flex the toes, kicking the heel out, flexing the toes back, out, stopping little by little, both legs locked, so got stomach in and in, elbows working down below. Now pull up on that right thigh a little bit more, press that big right toe down a little bit stronger. As you're ready, chin in, stomach in, forehead, meet in the knee, and it's a statue-esque moment here. Four, three, two, one, and reverse out. Awesome, really, really good, Dan. Just gotta give that hands on the hips, that quick little backward bend. Awesome work, everybody. Working hard, let the head drop back, and then we got standing bow. So let's keep those toes, heels together, and let's take that time in the setup, right? Strong setup leads to a strong posture, so you know the grip. We get right arm out, palm up, straight down for that inside grip. As we got inside grip, we're going to go knees together for alignment. We just worked on your left leg, right? It's 10 feet below the ground. Now, same time, left arm, once you feel like you might just touch the ceiling or the sky. Whole left side energized. We got chin up, stretch up, and give me a strong kick back and up, back and up. And I want you to think very specifically about the direction of the kick. You're not kicking left. You're not kicking right. It's very specific. Back and up. You let your hand receive the kick. You kick back and up. You feel that beautiful curve in the spine. Now, all the while, chin up, chest lifted, and that left arm solid like a sword. Your elbow locked, tricep lit up, five fingers, including the pinky finger with the other fingers, aim into the eyes. You get a strong kick. You got a strong stretch. You balance forever. Now, 15 seconds, steady. Troll, a little deeper, breathe, kick so much. See, toes over the middle of your head. Kick more, that left arm reaching forward, chin to the left shoulder. Right shoulder sits back. Now turn on the kick. Body down. Reach for it. Give me a strong kick. Four. Reach for kick. All right. Nice strong kick again. And then we're going to find your breath. I know we're all working so hard. And then we just let a nice deep inhale, exhale, kind of let things settle down. And then we're in it for the last of the minute postures on the left side. We go left arm out, palm up, straight down for that inside grip. All right, so we'll go knees together for a lemon. Right leg 10 feet below the ground. Right arm reaching up. And whole right side energize. Chin up, stretch up, and better be a strong kick. Back and up, back and up. And especially first set, not so anxious to get the body down right away, right? Let the kick gradually, gracefully bring the body down, easing your way into it with that chin up, chest lifted, and that right arm solid, right? You have to have a strong kick, but you have to have a strong stretch, right? You can't have a strong kick, wimpy stretch, right? It doesn't work out. You kick with all your might. You stretch forward with all your might. Law of physics, you balance for eternity. Now, strong kick, so much so we're going to see toes travel right over the middle of your head for alignment. Now, kicking more. That right arm reaching forward. Left shoulder sits back. Eventually, we get those shoulders in line. Now, give me 12 seconds. Concentrate. Meditate. Feel like you might fall. Kick. Body down. Kick. Reach for a kick. Feel like you might just touch your eyes and kick the sky. Awesome. Looking good, everybody. And we reverse out. And just find your breath. So I know sometimes we want to kind of move around all over the place, but challenge is to be still, breathe, let all that good work assimilate. And then we look forward to second set, of course, half the time, twice the fun. So let's get right arm out, palm up, straight down, inside grip. All right, so we'll go knees together. Left leg 10 feet below the ground. Left arm reaching up to the sky. Now one point focus. Reach up to the ceiling, give that strong kick, back and up, back and up. Beautiful curve in the spine, chin up, chest lifted, that left arm solid. Now strong kick, strong stretch, steady breath, turn the corners of your mouth upside down, so get body down, kick, stretch forward, kick. Now kicking like a maniac, more hard, reach forward and kick and kick and kick. Yeah, nice three sets to get it reversed out. Give me one more. Last side set, 30 seconds of your day. We go left arm out, palm up, straight down for that inside grip. So go knees together for alignment. Right leg 10 feet below the ground. Right arm reaching up to the sky. All comes from you. 30 seconds, you reach up. It's your kick, gradually, gracefully bringing your body down. Simultaneously, your right arm is stabilizing your balance. You got a strong kick. Strong stretch, steady breath, balance forever now, especially 10 seconds with control. Body down and kick. Reach forward and kick. You might fall, you kick, and you kick more, and you kick harder, and chest down, and reach forward and kick, and kick, and kick. Awesome, looking good. First out. All right, find your way to the back of the mat. We got our 10-second posture in. No time to waste. Make up your mind right about now. Anything for 10 seconds. Working your heart as a muscle. So let's get arms up. Lock. Biceps against the head. Palms tight as you can. Inhale, go to lengthen. We go right leg, step, lock in, go. Body down, leg up. It's right down, parallel to the floor. Capital letter T time. Chest down in, leg up. Lock the knee, point the toes. Kick out the back wall. And you reach and you touch the mirror. Asana, start to step back. So one more. Inhale, go to lengthen. We go left leg, step, lock in it. Again, just 10 fearless seconds. Understanding it's better to suffer 10 seconds than 10 years. So we stretch forward. Backward, like I'm pulling you from the front, back, literally tearing the body apart, stretching the heart, stretch. Okay, step back, arms down, stand still, tall, chin up, chest open, and breathe. Awesome, let's take that pivot, whatever it works for you, but we're gonna come to the left of your mat, taking it down a notch here as we're lowering the heart rate down. So toes, heels together for separate leg stretching. Do one set of this. We're going to get arms up. So we're going to lengthen in. Big step, 4 feet, arms down. So get arms down right away. We got heels in line, big toes in. Stretch the arms out. Now stomach in. Give me that swan dive down, nice and slow. Arms back, chest open. Hinging down. You know, once you meet initial resistance, that's going to look. Grab towards your heels from the outside, bending the knees as you need to, and then working your best grip. If it's not the heels, maybe a little towards the baby toes, the ankles, or maybe for today you place the hands in front of you, just working that stretch in the back of the legs. Now, know where you are, right? If you get your grip and your legs are bending, you're not thinking forward to the floor, right? You're thinking lock the legs, little by little, pushing the knees back, lifting the hips. Now, as your legs lock, that means no knees, thighs tight. Then you start thinking forward to the floor as you pull with the upper body strength. Inhale for strength. Exhale as you pull with elbows right alongside the calves. Now pull, pull chest right through that wind of the legs in that middle spine. Now look. We're going, ultimately that four right on floor between the toes. Feel that stretch all over the back legs, down spine, out thighs tight, hollow out the stomach. And I know some of you pretty darn close, four to the floor. So go for it, roll forward, pull forward, floor. Awesome. That step at the end, and then we change. We got arms out, chest open, and we're going to step right foot back. We got arms up, down, and then we're going to stand tall, Dan. Breathe. Standing at the peak of the mountain, we're going to go right in for your master posture. Triangle pose works. Everything. Arms up. So we're going to lengthen in. Big step. 4 feet, arms down. So arms down right away, ankles below the wrist. We're going to turn right foot out, parallel to the wall in front of you. Now push the hips forward a bit. And let's give it a few big bounces of that right knee. Bounce, bounce, down and down. I want you to hold it down to your lowest point, probably lower than you like to. Hold, freeze, arms back, go. Right elbow in front of the right knee. Left arm stretching up. Now visualize those hands on a clock. Reach up, where's 12 o'clock? Reach straight up to the sky. Down at 6 o'clock, we try to go. Chin to the left shoulder, that breath flows steady and out of the nose. Most important ingredient. Now engage the left thigh. Stomach and keep it in. Breathe steady, finish strong. Gonna push into the knee. Twist the upper knee back, open the chest, and you feel like you might just touch the ceiling under the sky. And then out, I'm gonna go other way, right foot in, left foot out, push the hips forward and bounce, bounce into that left knee. Get down and down low, hold it low. Once we get our arms back, go left elbow in front of the left knee, right arm stretching up. Go chin to the right shoulder. Got to look up at the ceiling or up at the sky. Now reaching, stretching without stopping. Internally stretching the heart of the lungs all the while. Engage the right thigh. Stomach and in. Engage the right gluteal muscle as well. Now press that right foot down to the floor as you push into the knee and twist the upper knee back. Open the chest. Reach, touch the ceiling. And this kind of to go. Reverse out. Right foot in. Arms up, down, and just right here. It's got to be chin, chin up, chest open, and breathe. Working every muscle, joint, organ, gland. Couple deep breaths. We hit that reset, and we're right in for the redo. Same thing, nice and strong. We get arms up. Lengthen in. Big step. 4 feet, arms down. So get ankles below the wrists. Pivot. Right foot out, parallel to the wall in front of you. So gotta push the hips forward, bounce under the right knee. A few big bounces down. Down low. Now we'll hold down low, freeze, arms back, go. Right elbow in front of the right knee. left arm stretching up, fire shooting through the fingertips. You're reaching, stretching. That's without stopping intermission. And as we go, moment by moment, breath by breath, you got to choose. Never give up, give in. You got to drop left hip down a little as you push into the knee and twist the upper body back. Go from the marrow to the heart, lungs, reach, ceiling to the sky, there's space, and then out. Last side set, right foot in, left foot out. Push the hips forward and bounce, bounce on that left knee. A few big bounces, hold it low, freeze, arms back, go. Left elbow in front of the left knee. Right arm stretching up. At this point, all out, tug of war, fingertip to fingertip without stopping, without intermission. That line of energy shooting through the chest, open that marriage in the heart, lungs. You gotta breathe steady and finish stronger. Gotta drop right hip down a little as you push into the knee and twist the upper body back and reach up where? Ceiling to the scatter space. Awesome. Strong to the end. And then we got right foot back, arms up, down, stand. Beautiful. Making our way downhill. Couple more. We're on the floor. So standing separate leg forward to the knee. Arms up, lock. We go hands in prayer, thumbs crossed. We're going to lengthen in. Step 3 feet. Let's pivot on the heels. So now the back foot is your left foot, 45 degrees. Flex the left hip a few times or square the hips to the wall in front of you. Lock the arms. Now let's get that throat choke, chin in, and take your time rounding in. Understanding the more you round into it, the better you're going to do in the posture, right? Pretty much. Kind of in the posture, just round the spine as much as you can. That's the point. Now, as you're down there, hands on either side of the foot for balance. Bend the knee as you need to get forward of the knee. Right? Unfortunately, we don't call it nose to knee. It's not air to forehead, right? So we're all journeying that forehead to the knee. I don't care how far away your forehead is from the knee. What I care, are you getting it closer? Millimeters or miles here. So hollow out the stomach. Trapped in the middle spine up. And with that chin in, throat choking, you choose temporary suffering for lifetime benefits forward. Somewhat higher, little bits a lot. Hold, freeze, hands in prayer so you could balance without anticipation. Slower than you want. Stack vertebra slow, build that control. Chin's going to become a last. Yeah, nice control all the way up. Now let's take that pivot, and we pivot one more time. This time, back foot is the right foot, 45-degree angle. Flex the right hip a few times. Square the hips. Lock the arms. Look at that throat choke. And then again, the more you round into it, the better. So curling into that ball. And we're all on that journey, right? Exact forehead to exact knee. Now, I know some of you might have forehead to the knee. Now your journey is hairline to the knee, right? It never ends. But wherever you are, keep working, progressing, right? We never want to be static. Same place, same time, every time. So little by little, hollowing out the stomach. Tractioning that middle spine up with that chin in. Throat choking. You make it happen. It's not going to happen for you. For it a little teeny something closer to the knee. Now hold, freeze. Hands in prayer so you could balance without coming out. Slower than you want. Press that big left toe down, big left foot down, and then round your spine slow. Build that core control. Chin's going to be coming up last. Really nice on the exit. Let's take that pivot, right foot back, so arms down. All right, we're going to close out, as always, more of a meditative posture before we hit the floor. So let's find yourself, same stance we started, practice toes, heels together again, tree pose, Tadasana. All right, we talked about it before, your left leg, 10 feet below the ground, and let's go right leg up, grab your foot, work it up as high as you can under the thigh. So that left leg is your root, 10 feet below the ground, we'll go right hand in prayer. Now, as you root down, of course, you always grow up, and that's literally grow. Lengthen the spine, chest, that little bit taller, looking tall, proud. Now, strong, sturdy tree as you're ready. Toe stand, look 4 feet in front. Hinge at your hips nice, slow. So as we hinge at the hips little by little, fingers are going to touch the floor. That's going to bend the knees, sit on the heel. Right, tree, we keep rooting down, lengthening up, breathing out of the nose, right? Mouth closed, breathing out of the nose. Now, the toes stand down there, arms alongside your hips. Now, you're ready to test your balance. Just go left hand, right hand for Namaskar. As for Namaskar, you can lift your gaze. Lift off the heel a little bit. Balance and focus wherever you are. Looking good, toe stand. Now tree, patiently waiting, toe stand, transition back to tree the opposite way. Okay, right leg comes down. One more. Closing out strong together. Okay, left leg up, grab your foot, find your balance and your focus. And of course, a lot of us stay here building your foundation in tree. Awesome, right? Make sure you're rooting that right leg 10 feet below the ground, stomach in, and you're growing, lengthening spine, chest. Look tall, proud. Now, if you're feeling pretty comfortable in tree, let's explore toe, right? We're gonna look 4 feet in front, hinge at your hips nice and slow. Eventually, fingers to the floor. That's where we're gonna bend the knees, sit on the heel. Okay, sit on the heel, arms alongside hips. Balance from that core, right? Scooping that stomach in, lengthening the spine, chest, and ready to test balance. Just go left hand, right hand, Namaskar. And as you're ready, we lift your gaze, lift off the heel. We strengthen the knee and concentrate and meditate and balance and focus. Looking good, toe stand tree, patiently waiting, toe stand, maneuver back up to tree opposite way. Awesome, left leg down, give that nice deep breath, acknowledging your hard work. And let's relax, right? So this is where you just start to lay down your back, settling into the floor for the rest of the class. Okay, so we're gonna start Savasana. And I want you to treat this like every other posture in the sense it always starts with the form. Now, of course, Savasana is the easiest posture in the setup. You just get your heels together, feet float out, arms alongside, palms up. Easiest setup, hardest posture to master, of course. This is where we're learning to be still. Now, of course, we all know being physically still is challenging in itself. On top of that, a little more challenging is being physically still, mentally still. So we're going to start focusing on your breath only. Nice deep inhale, belly rise. Deep exhale, belly falls, right? Just little by little, all you care about. Belly rising, falling as you allow that floor hold you up, sinking deeper and deeper. Ultimately, it's like you're floating in the ocean, completely weightless, relaxed. We're going to start up with wind removing pose, Pavanatasana, your toes, heels together for alignment. We're going to go right leg up, tight grip right below the knee. And let's work the knee slightly out, avoid the rib cage, and then steady down to the shoulder. All the while, gaze down towards your chest, lengthen in the neck, and as you keep working closer to the shoulder, get an inhale for strength, exhale, get a pull. Now we got stomach in and in. Biceps bulging, and with any and all strength, deep breath, you go, pull, squeeze, tighter, freeze, and release. So go right leg down, so other side, left leg up, then maybe switch the grip the opposite way for balance, interlocking the fingers, and going to work the knee slightly out, avoid the rib cage, and that knee is in the direct root to the shoulder, each evolution of breath, working it closer to the shoulder as you pull, not less, more, inhale, strength. Exhale, pull, let's go. Stomach in and in. Use that core, biceps bulging, core of the upper body strength. Inhale, exhale, pull, squeeze. As you release, right in, both legs up. Look to grab opposite elbows over the knees or as far as you can grab. once you get your best grip, we're going right in for that big hug. Each evolution of breath, a bigger hug. That's the point. So you got to inhale strength. Exhale, get a pull, maintaining a steady, constant pull, hugging yourself, not less, more, all the while, gaze down towards your chest, get that lengthening in the neck, and you see that little diamond shape between the forearms and the knees as you go for it. Biggest hug, deep breath, pull, squeeze, tighter, freeze. As you're releasing, it's immediately relaxing with your arms alongside, palms up, and breathing long and deep. Okay, we give that a chance to settle, and let's go right in for that first of many sit-ups. Toes, heels, touch, flex, toes to the face, arms over the head, cross thumbs, stomach on a breathing, come up, double exhale, grab toes forward to the knees. All right, let's turn around, lay down on the stomach. Go right in for that spine strength in a series. Cobra pose, so good for your lower spine, but especially with any lower back issues, this is one you want to work a little extra harder in. So we lay down in the stomach. Hands close to the chest, line the fingers up at the tops of the shoulders, the elbows up and in. Crazy, go those heels together, feet pressed down, inhale, gotta peel, chest up. So it's not a push-up, right? We peel the chest up and look up. Now it's where your eyes go, you go. So keep looking up and going up, chest up, look up. And as we go, tighten the legs, good. It's gonna be a little more up, elbows in, and then release and relax. Left ear to the towel, arms to your side. And I want you to make sure that left ear completely immersed into the towel. You're getting that nice stretch in the neck as you relax. Round two, line the fingers up, tops to the shoulders, elbows up and into the body, and let's get some extra crazy go on those heels. One leg like a cobra's tail, heels together, feet pressed down, inhale, gotta peel chest up. And as you peel chest up, we gotta look up and just keep looking up, going up, chest up, look up. And as we tighten the legs, glutes, we go a little more, can so do, up. Awesome, good, nice, slow on the way down. This time, right ear to the towel, arms to your side, and turning the head the opposite way, right? We're trying to open up that full range, 180 motion of your neck as you relax in between. Okay, now locust pose, palms face down in the towel, and we're trying to get the pinkies to touch, right? So do that little kind of shuffle back forth, working those elbows, pinkies as close as you can underneath the body. Once we work on that, we got chin out, nice stretch in the neck and the throat. Your right leg is solid and up, 45 degrees. Engage right thigh, lock knee, and as you point toes back to the back wall, extend the leg, lift a little more, hold, and release. Relax right, lock left, and lift. Engage the left thigh, lock knee, and as you point toes back while I can punch a button in the back wall, a little bit more, hold, and release. So mouth on top, kiss the towel, gotta rock back forth, elbows closer, palms flat. Extra crazy, go on those heels, give it that deep breath, and just go, both legs up. You shift all the way to the shoulders, use all upper body strength. You're also using your hands, right? You're pressing the hands, fingers to the floor, shifting more shoulders, struggle, push, try, legs up. Slow on the way down. Awesome effort. I know how it is. That little extra effort at the end, right? Working hard, it's going to pay huge dividends for your posture, right? Opening things up, getting that tremendous strength in that upper spine, opening up those elbows, wrists, hands, fingers. So let's do it again. Palms face down. Try to work those pinkies, elbows a little bit closer, second set as you can. All right, once we work on that, we got chin out, nice stretch in the neck, throat, right leg solid and up. Give me 45 degrees. 10, 9, 8, 7. 6, 5, stretch it. 4, 3, 2, 1. So relax, right, lock, left, lift. We got 10, 9, 8, Seven, six, stretch, four, three, two, one. So mouth on towel, kiss towel, elbows close, your palms flat. Tighten the leg, crazy go the heels, and make up your mind. Deep breath and just go. 10 seconds, 110% effort. You shift all the way into the shoulders. Use all upper body strength. Now, don't care how high you got a bike carry. You try to get higher. Four, three, more. Awesome. Good. Nice to assess. Good effort on the way. Shake it out. Let it go like it never happened. And breathe. Let's fly. Spread your arms out, tighten the leg up. So let's go chin out, extra crazy on those heels. We're going to press the hips down, the rest of the body in the air. So hips down and everything up. Go arms up, chest up. Now where do we look? Up. Got to breathe, studying out of the nose. So got breath by breath. Go chest up, legs up. Now, as you know, spreading those wings is not to fly down. It's everything. A little more. Up. And it's always that smooth land, avoiding that crash landing. Left ear to the towel and just breathe long, deep, relaxing and refueling, right? Energizing your body with those long, deep breaths. Oxygen is energy, filling up your tank. So you're ready to fly again. Spread those wings, tighten the leg. Heels together, press the hips down, give it that deep breath, and just go for it. Fly, arms up, chest up, and look up. Keep that breath flow, steady and out of the nose, your flute. And let's go, inhale, chest up, legs up. And as you're spreading those wings, cross the room, I want you to go, everything, go, fly. And then smooth land. Right here to the towel. Okay, bow pose, get that grip right below the toes, outside grip. We're gonna work the knees, feet together as you can, and working your whole spine in unison, lower, middle, upper spine. So once again, once you have that outside grip, we're gonna press the hips down, give it that deep breath, and give it a strong kick. The kick, peel body up, and then we look up, and it's very simple. You just look up, and you kick up, and you breathe. Now, as you kick, balance on the center of the stomach, and kick, shoulders relax back, and as you look higher, kick harder, head up, kick, and then as you release, immediately relax. Like it ever happened. Okay, so let's go for round two. Same thing, nice, strong. 20 seconds. Get your grip. Make up your mind. You can do this. Outside grip, knees, feet together to start. We're gonna press hips down. Give that deep breath and just start. Kick, strong kick. Now peel body up and you look up, and again, simple, look up and kick up and breathe. Now, as you kick with the thighs glued, shoulders relaxed back, it's time to look higher, kick harder, now, secret weapon, you smile, breathe, head up and kick. Awesome, nice start you got. Right ear to the towel, few deep breaths up and down the spine. And now you push up to the top of the towel. Going in for fixed firm next. All right, so as we come now top of the towel, first things first is we're gonna sit in between your heels. Now, never forcing this one, especially open up the knees, ankles. We wanna be a little gentle working into those joints, but see what's available, right? We're looking to open up the heels, hip width distance ultimately. You can sit your butt in between the heels. Now, if that's not happening, no worries, right? Stay a little more upright, open the knees as you need to. It's not about what it looks like. It's more about how it feels. You go where it feels a bit uncomfortable. Now, some of you comfortable with your butt on the floor, okay, start to go down right elbow, left elbow, and listen to the body. It's always communicating, right? You go to that initial discomfort, right? You don't go beyond that initial discomfort where it's very uncomfortable. That's not productive, right? You find manageable discomfort and you breathe, right? Whatever you do, you're breathing long, you're breathing deep, and we take a few deep breaths together. Nice, long, deep inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Okay, one more. Fill up the lungs. Empty them out. And let's go nice and slow as you come up, one arm at a time. Head's gonna come up. And then as you're up, we do look for that quick, smooth transition to the floor to your breath, maximizing this time. So opening up those knee, ankle joints, fresh blood, synovial fluid rushing into them as you relax. Let's go half tortoise, flex feet, arms over the head, stomach and a breathing calm. Up, double exhale, grab toes, four to the knees. All right, middle of your towel, knees, feet together, sitting on your heels, stretching the spine out. Once you're sitting on the heels, just to get arms up, lock. So we go hands in prayer, thumbs crossed, arms as far behind. Inhale, we're gonna lengthen up, slow exhale on the way down. Now, emphasis on slow, right? Especially on the towards the way down, a little bit slower. Try to avoid that crash landing, right, as you can. And then we go forehead, pinkies to the floor. And then we got arms locked, palms glued, and we get to work, right? You walk the pinkies up little by little, you traction the tailbone back. It's that opposite forward stretch. Arms, shoulders forward, tailbone backward. Now all the while, I want you to breathe long, deep, right? Try 5 second inhale, 5 second exhale, long, deep breaths for good for relaxation, rejuvenation, longevity as well, right? We're in tortoise pose. A tortoise takes a minute inhale, minute exhale, large reason they live hundreds of years. So keep breathing long, actively stretching, stretching, and with the knees, palms glued, and a flat back, we're gonna hinge up slow. Chin away from the chest, chin up. Okay, we get arms down and we're not gonna turn around. We're gonna go right on top of those knees, camel time. We're gonna measure about two fists between the knees, feet right behind, and hands on those hips like your hands on the back pockets. Now, elbows as far behind, already open in the chest. We ease into it. Inhale, gonna lift the chest head. Exhale, we're gonna drop your head back. Now, as soon as you drop your head back, you're officially in camel pose. Whatever you do, you breathe long, deep and out of the nose. Push the hips forward, lift the chest, and let the head drop back. As you let the head drop back, if you see halfway down the middle of the wall, gonna grab your heels, thumbs outside, fingers inside, tight grip. As you exhale, hips forward, forward, inhale, we lift the heart up. The whole front side is wide open. You're breathing long, breathing deep. You're breathing through it ever. Breathe into it and through it. Let's open you up. Exhale, hips forward. Part inhale, lift open the heart up. Let's go hands on hips. Head's gonna come up. Now, whatever you're feeling, turn around, lay down, and feel it in Savasana as you're breathing long and deep. Right? Learning whatever comes up for you, right? Whether that's good, bad, indifferent, you're laying down, breathing long, deep, right? Just energy moving through the body. So let's go for it again. Flex feet, arms over the head, stomach and a breathing calm. Up, double exhale, grab toes, four to the knees. Go top of the towel, stand top of the knees. We're gonna measure that. Two fists between the knees, feet right behind, and then we got elbows as far behind the body. And once again, we ease into this. Inhale, gotta lift the chest head. Exhale, we're gonna drop the head, and just most importantly, I want you to make sure you're breathing long, deep throughout, especially when it gets a little overwhelming. That's when you need to breathe long and deep, right? Open yourself up, little by little, hips forward, chest up. Now, if you see halfway down the wall, okay, grab your heels. If not, don't worry about it, right? Most importantly, feel that whole front side stretch, and as you breathe long, exhale, hips forward, forward, inhale, heart up. Now, so go whole front side wide open. I want you to keep breathing long, Breathing deep. That's directly into the heart. Now give me 10 more seconds right here. Now open up your heart. Not later, right now and now. As you breathe, breathe, exhale, hips forward. Heart inhales, go lift, open heart up, ceiling to the sky. And let's go hands on hips, head up. And it up and around. Again, whatever you're feeling, breathe. Awesome. And just holding it here. It's so good, Maria. Awesome, Dan. Beautiful, beautiful. And as we come up, and whatever you're feeling, again, just a few deep breaths. And taking comfort. And a lot of the times, feel uncomfortable now. Indication, I'm going to feel wonderful later, right? Just letting go. A lot of tension. We're gearing up towards the end. Few more postures. We're going to go into rabbit pose. This is your deepest forward bend. Flex feet, arms over the head. Stomach under breathing. Come up. Double exhale. Grab toes. So we'll go middle of your towel. Knees, feet together. Sitting on your heels. We're going to wrap the towel over the heels. Grab thumbs outside. Fingers inside. Nice grip. We're sitting upright with your chin in. Throat choking. And then we're going to round in. So we're going to curl into it as much as you can. We want to get top of the head of the towel. And now if there's a gap, we're going to try to walk knees to forehead as you can, one by one. And then we start to pull. Make a handful of heel. Got to pull and lift the hips up and lift the butt up. We got stomach in. And roll forward and forward. I got to hollow out the stomach. Roll forward, forward. The arms are going to lock. We smash arms against legs. Shoulders up from the ears as you pull stomach in. Give me hips a millimeter up sky. And then hip down. One time, chin's going to come up. Ask for that quick turn around, lay down in a ninja-like fashion right to the very end. Okay, strong sit-ups. Keep them going. Flex feet, arms over the head. Stomach under breathing. Come up. Double exhale. Grab toes. Four to the knees. All right, middle of your towel. Knees, feet gather, sitting on those heels. Use the towel. Wrap it over the heels. Grab the heels. Thumbs outside. Fingers inside. And all right, again, sitting upright. We get that throat choke. Stomach in. And the more you round into, the better. So take your time curling into it. Top of the head of the towel. And again, a lot of us, there's going to be a gap between the knees, forehead, normal. Best you can, try to walk knees to forehead and then start to pull. Now, some of you might have your knees, your forehead and knees touching, right? If that's the case, right, I want you to think about kind of pressing your forehead into those knees, creating a pressure there as you start to pull and lift the hips up to the shoulder of the sky. So pull, stomach in. Roll forward. I'll think in a hollow out the stomach. Roll forward. There are no arms. Your arms, are no elbows. Your elbows locked. Now smush the arms against the legs. Smush those heels together best as you can. Now press feet down to the earth and pull hips that millimeter up sky. Awesome. So go hips down. So you got to unwind spine. So we got chin up. All right. And that quick turnaround. Lay down and we're right in, home stretch. Two more postures, one set of each. Let's do it. Flex feet, arms over the head, stomach under breathing, calm up. Double exhale, grab toes, four to the knees. Spin around, right leg out, left foot in. Your right leg's out at 45 degrees, and we're going to go separate leg stretch. Arms up, lengthen, twist, chin in, round in, and let's go. Forehead to knee. Now bend the knee as much as you need to get that forward of the knee. Now, of course, if you can get the hairline to the knee, not going to complain about that. And then we get a 10-finger grip below the toes. Now go, push the forehead deeper into the knee. Kick the heel out, flex toes, little by little, right leg lock. Just go right leg lock, elbows down, hug the calves, kick the heel out, flex the toes, pull, and change. Go other way, so switch up. So we got left leg out, right leg in. So got a lengthen, twist, chin in. Round in, and let's go. Forward of the knee. Bending the knee as you need. Tight grip below the toes. And just every little bit counts, right? Millimeters, miles here as you push the forward deeper into the knee. Kick the heel out. Flex the toes. Kick and flexing. Eventually, left leg lock. Elbows right down to the calves. Kick, flex, pull. Chance. So we got both legs out. Lay down. As soon as you're down, of course, you're up. Double exhale, grab toes, four to the knees. Give me the middle index finger, hook them around the big toes. And then do a little dance, shake hips out, right, left, loosen up a little bit. And then first things first, we got to lock your legs, right? So we want to kick the heels forward, flex the toes so the legs eventually lock. Now, as your legs lock, thighs tight, stomach in. Inhale, got to lengthen, stretch up out of the waist. Exhale, got to pull. Now I want you to look where you're going. So you're looking at your toes, ultimately it's forehead to toes. Don't care if you're nowhere close forward to the toes, you're on your way there, millimeter by millimeter. Inhale, lengthening. Exhale, pull. Chin forward, look forward. Now some of you are pretty close forward to the toes, right? So I want you to think about biting your toes. Inhale, lengthening. Exhale, pull, pull forward to the toes, pull. Awesome, let's go lay right down, arms over your head. We'll go right in for that strong sit-up. Double exhale, grab toes, four to the knees. All right, as we go in, final posture, face whatever works for you, spinal twist, you're gonna bend the left knee in line with the belly, right foot comes up over the knee, flat down, right arm behind the spine, keep it straight, left arm up over the knee. Right, we're gonna push into the knee, look over the right shoulder and twist. Inhale, we're gonna lengthen the spine, chest, head. Exhale, go over the shoulder now, stomach in and in. Push into the knee. Now lean a little bit into that right hip. So you got to lift the chest, head, look over that right shoulder. See something new over that right shoulder. You got to twist and twist and twist. And so you got to release. All right, other way. Got bend the right knee, line the right knee with the belly. We go left foot up over the knee, flat down, left arm behind the spine. We go right arm up over the knee. By pushing the knee, look over the left shoulder, and let's twist. Warm up the whole time, twist the spine. Inhale, lengthen the spine, chest. Exhale, go over the shoulder. Now stomach in, working on that lower spine. Think about pushing the elbow into the knee, feel opening in the middle of the spine. Now let's lean a little bit into that left hip. Get a little bit taller, lift the chest head. Now look that little farther of the left shoulder and twist, twist, last chance, twist. All right, let's release. Lay right down your backs. As always, as we final sit up is your best one yet. So let's do it. Flex feet, arms over the head, stomach and a breathing. Come up, double exhale, grab toes, forward to the knees. And let's go. Final breathing, Kalabhati breathing, your cleansing breath. Sit knees, feet together on your heels. And sitting nice upright, grab the knees so your arms lock, spine straight, and focusing on the exhale. The inhale is automatic. So together with the exhale, we're going to follow this pace. Go. Stomach in, exhale, air, out, stomach in, exhale, air, out, stomach in, exhale, air, out, faster, stomach in. It's all coming out right about now. Stale there, thoughts, get them out. Stomach in, stronger. 10, 8, 7, 6, 5. Awesome job, buddy. Working so hard today. So seal your practice, whatever way works for you. And then just as you're ready, just give it some time. Lay down, do nothing. That's you receive everything of your hard work. Now, final part, final savasana, it is still part of the practice, right? And this might be the most important part of your practice, right? Learning to integrate, assimilate all that hard work you've been doing, learning to relax, right? It's one of the main reasons we do this. So just spread out a little bit more as you like, your arms, legs, close your eyes. And it always comes back to your breath, your anchor. Nice deep inhale, belly rise. Deep exhale, belly falls. Long deep breaths. Allow your body to scan, sink deeper and deeper till eventually floor is holding you up as if you're weightless, floating in the ocean, completely relaxed. Understanding, work the whole body, head to toe, bones to skin. So you're going to do a quick little scan of your body now. From your head down into your toes, just relax the top of your head, your scalp. Letting your brain sink a little bit deeper, your eyes fall deeper in the sockets, relaxing your forehead, your jaw, your cheekbone, whole face. Relax, right? And following that relaxation down into your throat, Opening up your throat, your self-expression here, opening your throat, finding that relaxation, traveling down your shoulders. Any tension there is melting away. No need to carry it around. Relaxing the shoulders, finding that relaxation, traveling down your arms, relaxing your biceps, relaxing your biceps. Elbows revitalize, recharge, relaxing your forearms, your wrists revitalize, recharge. All the way down to your hands, your thumbs, all the way into the pinkies. Revitalize, recharge, and we're going to find that opening in the heart, right in the center of your chest. Open the heart, and open the heart. And still feeling that up-down motion in your torso. Long, deep breaths, relaxing your torso, relaxing your torso. And this is where you find that relaxation. Going down into your hips, sinking a little bit deeper into the floor, relaxing your hips. And let's follow that relaxation all the way down to your legs, relaxing the thighs. Your thighs relax. Knees revitalize, recharge. Such important joints for stabilizing your posture throughout your day, throughout your life. Relaxing your calves relax. Revitalizing those ankle joints as well, right? Such an important part. And that strong, stable posture, and just relaxing your feet, all your toes right into the big toe, pinky toe, whole body revitalized, recharged inside out, bones of skin, all the way down into your hair. And give yourselves a few deep breaths on your own. Now, as always, I want you to keep this relaxation that you created with you throughout the day. Remember, don't let anybody steal your peace. Thank you for joining us. Namaste.